care physicians as well. So you're kind of doing this overlap or this stock overlap where you may have healthcare investments with the rest of your investments, but now you're saying, I want even more in this particular sector. So that's one issue. Number two, we don't own sector funds in any of our client portfolios. But we used to. We had financials, healthcare, tech, you know, some other different sectors, but we've chosen to move away from that. We want to take those dollars and put them into mutual funds or ETFs and let the managers figure out what they want to overweight, underweight in their own portfolios. So if you are absolutely dead set on holding it, I would want you to hold maybe only about 5%. Let me ask you this, do you own this in a taxable account or an IRA? Okay. So in the IRA, you can sell it without any worry about capital gains. In the taxable account, if you can sell maybe a little bit now and maybe a little bit next year, you're splitting any sort of gain issue that you have, and then you can take those dollars and then get those dollars to work throughout the rest of your portfolio rather than kind of overweighting even more this healthcare position.
Okay.
Let me know if you have other questions, but you got some work in front of you, okay?
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Andy would love to help you by answering your questions. Email those to askandy@investingsense.com or call us now at 888-833-8637. Andy, I mentioned this earlier. Seems like a reasonable goal. Hey, can we just squeeze out 1% more in the returns for my 401k, my IRA, and my investments?
Oh, my gosh. Sounds so easy.
It does.
Sounds so easy. It usually doesn't work. You know, there's a couple of things. There's actually three key things that we really try to make a point of with clients when we go through, you know, their plans with them. We look at how much they're saving and try to increase that. We look at what age they want to retire, and we try to figure out how to really maximize their Social Security, how to get more money out of them.
Strategies than just the kind of generic, hey, let's try and get 1% more on my returns. So start with the first one you mentioned, savings.
Yeah, I tell people all the time, save as much as you can for as long as you can. And it's because how much you save could actually have a much larger impact on your account size than your returns. And so you know that people focus on one whiz bank investment over another, or allocation to this, or trying to market time, or anything else. But if you are a consistent and religious saver and try to save as much money into your 401ks, your IRAs as possible, that actually has a much stronger, or could have a much stronger impact on your returns down the road. So you take that and you combine it with the second point where we just try to figure out people's retirement ages. So you're saving more and you might be working 1 year longer, 2 years longer. You have more savings, you have more compounded returns, and for each day that you end up delaying retirement, you're shortening the amount of time that you need to live on your income. If you're working, you can still contribute to your 401k, so more savings. You can delay taking required minimum distributions, you're still on your employer's insurance, you have all this other stuff. So just those two things right there, saving more and then adjusting your retirement age. Forget about returns, this is the stuff that helps a lot.
So those are two powerful strategies you mentioned that has to do with Social Security.
Your favorite, money from the federal government, you know. So really what we're trying to do is try to get as much money out of Social Security for people as possible. And it's tough to figure out. There's 2,700 Social Security rules, and it's why the average retiree ends up leaving $100,000 in benefits on the table. The average couple could even leave $200,000 on the table, and this is money that's going to make up a huge portion
our needs and situations. Call me at 504-830-7676 or visit financialengines.com.
Welcome to Investing Sense, brought to you by Financial Engines. Every week we bring you straightforward advice for your financial future without the jargon, with insights from our panel of industry experts.